Hello students of 9th and 10th, welcome to DAV Mall Public School. I am your English teacher, Jagruti Mishra. Let's begin our today's online session of English. Today, we will study in detail models. Now let us see what are model verbs. Model verbs are also called as auxiliary verbs or simply models. They express the mood of a verb such as ability, possibility, necessity or another condition. Here is a list of modal verbs: shall, must, could, might, will, ought to, may, would, should, can. Now let us study modals in detail. Models expresses the mood of a verb such as ability, possibility, necessity or another condition. They are used with a main verb to form a sentence or a question. Models are not conjugated and normally cannot be used without a main verb. When used with modal verbs, except ought, main verb always remain in the infinitive without to. In a statement, the word order is subject plus modal plus main verb. For example, they can come. Here, they is subject, can is modal, and come is main verb. In the same way, she should walk. She is subject, should is modal, and walk is main verb. In questions, the word order changes to modal plus subject plus main verb. Let us see yes no questions. Modal, subject plus main verb. Can they come? Should she drive? Can is modal, they is subject and come is main verb. Should is modal, she is subject and drive is main verb. In WH questions, WH word plus modal plus subject plus main verb. When can they come? How could he know? When is WH word, can is modal, they is subject and come is main verb. In the same way, how is WH word, could is modal, he is subject and know is main verb. Now let us see the very first model, can. The model can indicates possibility or ability. Tom can help you. Wild animals can be dangerous. I can win this game. In questions, the model can request permission to do something or to ask about possibilities. Can I help you? Can Dhoni join our team? Who can answer the questions? When can we get back the results? Now let us see another model, could. Could indicates possibility or ability in the past. I could have told you that. When I was young, I could run very fast. Could speculates about future possibilities. In the following example, could and might are synonymous. It could or might rain tonight. That could or might be dangerous. In yes or no questions, could speculate about present possibilities. Could she be the murderer? Could this be a mistake? It can also make a request. In these examples, could and can are synonymous, but could is more polite. Could or can you open your window? Could or can you help me to move this sofa? Now let us see shall and will. The modals shall and will plus main verb are used to form future tenses. These modals indicate an intention or an action that is expected to happen in future. When used in statements, there is no difference in meaning between these two models. I will or shall close the door for you. Tarun will or shall meet us at the railway station. In WH questions, shall and will ask about options. Who will or shall drive the car? When will or shall I see you again? In yes or no questions, shall and will have different meanings. Will ask for the favor and shall ask about a preference. Will you turn off the TV? Here we will not use shall. Will you stop winning? Will also ask for information or knowledge about somebody or something. Will Tom ever pay you back? Will Mars be visited by humans within 20 years? Dear students, based on our today's topic, here is a short assignment for you. We will continue this topic in our next session. Have a nice day. Thank you.